Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So we meet again for still in chapter 2, which is the part 2 of the plastic compounding, which is today I will continue with the compounding machinery. The machinery that commonly used for compounding plastic are such as internal mixers, Z blade mixers, and dispersion mixers, and also twin screw extruder. Okay, this is the four types of equipment that commonly used for plastic compounding. Okay, the selection of the method determined by the conditions of the material, the volume of the end product required, and the sensitivity of the material to break down during the shear. So some of the material require different type of machinery in order to have to retain the properties, to prevent any breakdown during the shearing and during the compounding process. Okay, the compounding process includes two stages. Commonly, the first one is mixing the material, and the second one forming the mixture into pellet, sheet, rods or lumps. Okay, so different types of equipment produce the different types of mixture. Okay, either in pellet form, either in sheet form, rods or in a lump form. Okay, so basically, there are four basic methods used for compounding plastic with their additive: dry mixer, batch mixer, continuous mixer, and through extruder. I think we will go through one by one. The first one is the dry mixer. This is the illustration of dry mixer. Okay, dry mixer are preferred for powder plastic pellet with fibers and plasticizer with PVC. Powder are dry, finely grounded plastic and their ingredient. Plastic are often mixed with glass, carbon or metal fiber to increase plastic material strength and stability. And PVC plastic is rigid and must be mixed with lubricating additive called plasticizer to make it flexible. Okay. There are four types of dry mixer. Okay, before that, usually for dry mixers, they only use for mixing a compounding in a pellets and the final, what we call that, mix material is still in dry and in pellet forms. So it's not melted the material, not converting into a molten state. Okay, that's the dry mixer's behavior. Okay, so four types of dry mixer are further divided into the high speed impeller, ribbon mixers, pedal mixers, drum tumbler. And this is these types of dry mixer is commonly in industry. Some of the industry preferred a high speed impeller, but some of industry might use a pedal mixer for slow mixings, but more thoroughly distribution of the compounding ingredient. Some might also use drum tumbler. Usually, drum tumbler is a smaller size of dry mixers. Okay, and then control of the mixing process is important in this mixing, since fibers tend to clump together if the mixing process is too long. So dry mixer, usually you don't want to promote any clumping. You don't want to any your material to agglomerate together during the mixing process. You want to retain it in its original form, but the mixing process appear during the process. Okay, the capacity of low intensity mixers are the hundreds of pounds. The larger volumes are fed to extruder compounder. The normal cycle for the low intensive mixing of plastic with glass fiber usually takes from 10 to 20 minutes. So usually before you produce a fine product, or you use any extrusion, injection molding, or any rotational molding, blow molding, etc., you might want to mix your raw material if your raw material having multiple types of additive in order to have more homogeneous mixings. And then the mixer consists of enclosed container with high speed impeller mounted at the bottom, the impeller is similar to the rotating blades of a helicopter. Okay, similar illustration is helicopter blades, or we can also call it what we call this a ceiling fan. Okay, so the impeller will rotate it. Okay, we're rotating during the process to promoting more thoroughly mixings during the process. Okay. The impeller is capable of 80 to 3,600 revolution per minute. So it depends on your types of equipment, the capability of your equipment. And it also rely on your types of material. Okay, some sort of material did not require high RPM, the rotations of your impeller. Some supplements require very high in order to have a homogeneous mixing. And then the mixing is fast with material blended within 2 to 4 minutes per cycle. Some of the fast mixing may require only 2 to 4 minutes only. Okay, heat generated during the mixing process must be drawn off through a cooling jacket of the following reason. Okay, kenapa kena keluarkan generated heat ni? Because to retard decomposition of the material. Some of the material, such as the PVC, is very sensitive to heat. Okay, elevated heat might decompose your raw material during the process. Okay, next is to block the development of lump. Okay, because when heat generated or heat in that your drums or your mixing chamber increase significantly, your raw material or polymeric material will tend to soften a bit and it will start to clump together. Okay, we don't want to any to have any agglomeration of your material. You want to stay your material in its original forms. Okay, then we have the second one is a batch mixers. The second method used for compounding plastic with their additives. This is the illustrations of the batch mixers, or sometimes we call the internal mixers. Okay, or the Bembury mixer itself. Okay, it's or I think last semester we did cover in polymer machinery the Bembury mixers or the internal mixers. This is the illustration. I think you're very familiar with this. And I hope having this note, you will go through each of the equipments, each of the components of this batch mixers. Okay, the high intensity batch mixer is used for the process of high viscosity plastic. Okay, compared to that dry mixer, it can be used for high viscosity plastic. This plastic is used for the production of vinyl film, sheeting, and vinyl impregnated clothes. The best mixers are used to fit clandering process. The clandering process consists of large multiple rolls, then flattened to the mixed dough like a plastic into a flat sheet. Okay, so usually batch mixer and products, the produce lump. Also, this type of lump need to be flattened using a clandering machine. Okay, last semester I did cover on the clandering process. I think you're very familiar. It's similar, looks like a two-roll mill, but having a multiple rolls to flatten your raw material, okay, the mixed material, or in order to reach its desired thickness. And then the thermoplastic material of PVC, vinyl acetate, polyethylene, polypropylene, ABS, acrylonitrile, butadiene styrene, and impact modified polystyrenes are the most often used for the best batch mixers. Okay, the thermoset material of the melamine and urea are also batch mixed and then rolled into a flat stock for grinding into a molding powder. The specification of batch mixers. Batch mixers consists of enclosed steel chamber with internal rotating and intermeshing blades. The rotating blades smear the material against the container wall while the shear and knits the material at the center. After the cycle is complete, the globes of mixed material is then discharged, ready for clandering into a sheets or processing into a molding powder or a pellet. So, batch mixers will melt your material, convert into your raw material in terms of powder, granule, pellet, resin, etc., into a molten state, and then it will discharge as a globes of mixed material, and this blob will need to be sheeted using a clandering or any other finer machinery. Okay, so I think this one is similar to the illustration I showed earlier. And then the specification of batch mixer, a variation of batch mixer is the Banbury mixer developed in 1916. Okay. And then the Banbury mixer used two spiral shaped rotors and can be easily fit material through the tops. Okay, this is the what we call spiral shaped rotor in order to distribute the raw material and the batch of your mixing material. Okay. When material is discharged, the batch is complete and then exits through the a door at the sides. The combination of smearing and intensive working produced by batch mixer result in highly homogeneous mix. Okay, as compared to dry mixer, batch mixer having a better homogenization. Okay, excuse me. Okay, the combination, okay, this one I did mention earlier, okay. Next, batch mixer produce material in 2 to 4 minutes, okay, each batch. But it depends on amounts and the volumes that you mix by batch, okay. Batch mixer range in size with machine capacity from 2 to 150 pounds, okay. Next, the third compounding equipment is continuous mixers. Okay, a continuous mixer is similar to the Banbury mixers. Okay, previously we covered the Banbury mixer. Each of the compounding ingredients we put together and we mix until it melted and to produce a homogenized mix. But for continuous mixers, it's fed into a hopper while mixed and transported by intermeshing irregular screw device to the opposite end. So you put at one end, and finally, your mixed material will be, come up from the other opposite ends. And then the mixing takes place between the rotating screw and the chamber wall as the material is kneaded between the two screws and the scraps of the wall surface. The amounts and quality of material can be controlled by adjusting the rotating speeds of the screw and the amounts of material allowed to leave the chamber. The advantage of the continuous mixer over a batch mixer, it is the ability to provide a continuous mix of material with optimum dispersion. As compared to that batch mixer, you need to prepare batch by batch. So you need to measure your compounding ingredient, your additive, etc., batch by batch and mix batch by batch to produce your compounded material. But compared to the continuous mixer, you only put your material once and it will produce your continuous mix during the process. Then the continuous mixer is capable of production in quantities of 1,000 to 10,000 pounds per hour. So in terms of productions of continuous mixing material, Contour mixer having a higher and more consistent in production. The contour mixer significantly larger output provide the manufacture of PVC film with higher product rates, not possible with batch mixers. Some of the PVC manufacturers, such as PVC mats, require continuous mixings during the process. Finally, the third compounding method. The fourth compounding method is a single stage screw extruder. Okay, I think this one you very familiar. Okay. Screw extruder are the process tool used in compounding, injection molding, injection blow molding, extrusion, extrusion blow molding, etc. Okay, screw extruder consists of long auger screw that fill the opening of the steel tube. The plastic and additive that are placed at the ends of the screw are mixed and melted when the screw turns. And then understanding the mixing and melting capability of screw extruder is important in understanding compounding technology. They play a critical role in over 70% of the compounded plastic material. And yes, I agree. Vastly used equipment for compounding is a screw extruder because it's more efficient and can produce a high quantity at very short time. Okay, screw extrusion technology is used as a plastic mixing and melting device in four more plastic processes. These four processes consume over 80% of plastic material. Okay, a single screw extruder is classified by the ratio of the length of the screw to the inside diameter of the barrel. Standard extruder have 30-to-1 ratio. A 1-inch diameter extruder screw would be approximately 30 inch long. So it depends on your diameter. So the bigger your diameter of your screw, longer will be your screw or of extruder. The size of extruder range from a small laboratory model with 1/2-inch diameter barrels to UPS large production extruder with 8-inch diameter barrels. So if you multiply with the 30-inch for 1-inch of diameter, you will get a very long extruder screw. As the size of extruder increase, so does the ability to produce mixed plastic material. So, because as you are having a very long and bigger diameters of your screw extruder, it will promote longer times of mixing time in order for the raw material to travel from the hopper, which is you insert the raw material, to the end nozzle to produce a homogeneous mix. The screw is divided into three sections that are easily identified by changes in the root diameter of the screw. I think this one is very familiar. This one I would call the flashbacks, okay, from your previous previous semester. The first section, the root diameter main constant and the material is mixed. This section is called the mixing. Okay. The second section, the root diameter begin to expand, compress the material. This section called the compression section. Okay. The third section, the root diameter full expand and remain constant. In this section, the material completely mix and called mattering section. The three sections of the screw mix compress and homogenize the plastic between the screw flies and against the wall of steel tube. The rotation of the screw, the friction at the barrel wall, and the forward movement of the screw produce the three-way internal mixing pellet and additive. The mixing process takes place as the friction between the hot wall and the barrel and the plastic melt to the outsides of the plastic pellet. The rotating screw roll and tumbles the mixture back into a center of the space between the screw flight. The leading edge of the screw flight scrapes the melted plastic of the wall of the barrel and collect into an expanding pool. The mixing takes place in all three sections of the screw. Dry mixing in the first section, compression and melting in the second section, and finally complete homogenization in mattering section. Okay. The geometry of the screw, the root diameter, and the angle of the screw flight change to alter the mixing intensity. And the geometry and the diameters and the screw flight depends on different types of material that you want to mix. Okay, different types of polymer raw material that you use. The mixing action within the extruder is controlled by screw geometry, the speed of the screw, and the back pressure provided by the constrictions of the melt as it passes out the ends of the barrel. The geometry of the screw significantly affects plastic melting and mixing. The angle of the screw flight can be changed to reduce the shearing force on the plastic. The length of each section of the screw changes for different material. When the length of the compression section is increased, this reduces the shear intensity of the plastic. Okay, next is the compounding problem and remedial action. I think this is the last subchapter for chapter 2. Okay, there are two main problems that a compounder must solve when mixing plastic with additive. I think this is very important, please bear in mind. Okay, the plastic automatically repel organic glass filler and also form clumps of glass and globes of plastic during mixing. And the natural repulsion between the organics and inorganic matter is overcome by controlling the mixing process and the use of appropriate chemical coupling agent. Okay, the first issue is organic plastic are mixed with inorganic additive because they repel to each other. And then coupling agent have two chemical components that adhere to each other. One component easily coats and wet out the surface of the plastic, while other coats the glass fiber. The coupling agent is formulated for the specific plastic material and coated the glass surface prior to mixing. And then the second issue is the physical nature of some additive, the difficulty to disperse them evenly through the mixture, and additive of various size with sharp edge or rough surface will increase the viscosity of the plastic melt by interfering with the slip between molecules. If the additives are not uniformly mixed, batch to batch uniformity is difficult. Okay, this problem are addressed by selecting a correct compounding process for plastic material and additive, controlling the dry mixing and additive and material prior to compounding, formulating the master batch that are then dry mixed with the base plastic, and controlling the compounder's mixing ensuring stress. This is the end product industry that commonly used for compounding ingredient. I think that's all for this chapter. And thank you, and I hope to see you again next week with chapter 3. By then, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you.